It's a privilege to be here at Godolphin on what is still a very important week for Saeed Bin Suroor and his team here. Eight runners, you must be looking forward to this week, Saeed.
You know, we're excited to see our horses run well, but it's going to be a very tough meeting. All the best quality horses in the world are going to run on Saturday. The World Cup night, this is very important for us as for people in UAE, plus as the Arab people always they were looking to see us to do good in this meeting. And the best we've done so far, good. I mean, this year it is not easy. There is some quality of horses coming from everywhere in the world. The stars really coming. And we send the best eight horses from Godolphin, from Algo Stable to World Cup now to see, you know, to get the best result we can.
Would you say it's the most important day of your year?
We start as the carnival for almost 3 months, but Super Saturday, as what happened like 3 weeks before the World Cup, that's to give us the sign which one they're going to be good enough to run the World Cup night. But the World Cup night, this is as a special meeting for us as in UAE. Everybody in the world, they will focus and watch this races. And if we can win one race, it will be great for us.
Mm. Let's start by talking about the Gold Cup. You've got three in there, Gold Star, Natural Scenery and Red Galileo. Gold Star's possibly the most interesting in that he's trying this 2 miles for the first time.
Yeah, but the way he ran his race as a mile and a half, he saw he needed a trip. I talked to the jockeys for the 2 miles race, they said he can't stay. I mean, the way he looked and even trained in the morning, he didn't, he's a stayer. He looked like a stayer. We give him a chance in the 2 miles, but so far he's doing good, working well, in good condition, you know, and he's learning from every race he run. As the 2 miles race, we see how he goes, and it gives us also, you know, something good for the future as to run him in stayer races in Europe.
Yeah, he does look a very talented horse, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's a big, strong horse. Even as when he came, I mean, here, he was a little bit weak, but with time he improved physically. Then, you know, he's we run him in the 2 miles, we'll see how it goes with the filly and Red Galileo also.
Yeah, Red Galileo, do you think 2 miles is his best trip, or is he better over a bit shorter?
I think the mile and six, what the best result he done. But the way he run, give him a chance, 2 miles, it depends about the base, how fast they go. But if they go as a nice base, I think it will suit him.
And Natural Scenery, she's a lovely, solid filly. She's been okay in the carnival.
Yeah, she's a tough filly. She didn't show a lot really for us, but we hope, I mean, the 2 miles race will be better for her.
Let's move on and have a look at the Dubai Turf. Ben Battle, promising run, and Lesh Lab. Ben Battle's got to be probably one of your best chances on the night.
Ben Battle, he's a tough, very tough horse. As you know, we find him as early last year, you know, he won well first race, and that time gave us confidence to run him in nice races, run him in the Derby, finished fifth. Then from that time also, he improved physically, mentally, then he won the Royal Ascot Group 3. He came here to win Group 2, improved all the time, second in the Group 1 also. This is very another big step for him in Group 1 with the stars coming, very tough race, as usual. But he's in good form, always last piece of work worked well, and we're looking to see a good run from him.
Do you think last time it was just a case he was a bit wide, he was drawn in 10, I think?
The draw didn't help him, really. And I can see that when he jumped from the stalls, he wasn't really heavy, and it took him come from outside all the way. You know, the horse, he don't look really comfortable in the race. It looked like he's coming to win, but he got beat in the line. Mm. I mean, he's a tough horse, always, but I think the trip now for long would be suit him really better.
You've trained lots of very good sort of 9-10 furlong horses over the years. Would he be, you know, as good as some of those Group 1 winners you've had?
He's good, I mean, but still, I mean, I'm looking for to see him. We need something more from him, really, to show us. I mean, he improved all the time, but this is the race. Dubai Turf is another big step for him, you know, and if he win or run well, it gives us confidence for the future to run him big races in Europe.
Mm. Best Solution, been a good horse for you as well, a dual Group 3 winner. He goes in the Shima Classic. Last time, was he a bit disappointing?
I think the horse, he had problem in the race. You know, he pushed him out, and that's really changed the result completely. But I know he's much better than this. You know, the way he ran, the way he, what he done, he, even in England when he won Group 3, he won really well. And even he won also the Derby trial. The horse is improving. As mile and a half is a good trip for him, but like what you know, the best horses going to be in this three races, the World Cups, Shima Classic and Dubai Turf. But the horse, he doing well. We're happy with him so far. You know, it depends where is the draw, but if he's in a nice position, I think the horse have a good chance to run big race.
Let's talk about the big race, the Dubai World Cup. You've, of course, won it more than anyone else. Thunder Snow this year. How's he been doing since Super Saturday?
He's doing good. I mean, he won a race as second round Maktoum Challenge, but he got beat to the last round from the better horse as our horse. Physically, he looked good this year. He's always calm and relaxed in the race, but he didn't show us as what we really need from him. It was disappointing with him from last run. You know, I know he much better than this, but you know, we need to forget that race. I know he's a little bit moody in the race, but I hope the World Cup he changed his mind. So far he looked good, happy, fresh. As today he's jumping before he come out for his normal exercise. Then it depends about the race. I mean, it's 10 horses is going to be in the race, not big field, but. That's if he can't get the draw as in the middle, it will help him really a lot.
Mm. And do you feel he's as good on dirt as he is on turf? Because he's very unusual in that he's, you know, won big races on both surfaces.
He won last year the Guinness Plus UAE Derby, and he won also Group One for when he was 2 years and 3 years in Group One in France as in the turf. He can handle both surfaces. You know, but this is going to be another chance for him in the dirt in the World Cup, and we'll see how he goes. But so far, he's doing good.
And he only ever wins by a small amount, so I guess we don't know how good he is.
I know, but it depends about which kind of horses they're running. Really, I mean, the Carnival horses always going to be in nice horses, but the World Cup it could be very good horses. It's a different class, you know. But the horse he's trying good, always he do good. But if he's in good position, always, I mean, nice and handy, stay away from the kickback, I think the horse have a good chance to run big race.
Has the way the track's been riding bothered you at all? Obviously, horses that are on the front seem to do better at Maidan this year.
Well, it depends how the base, really. I mean, the surface looked very good. Mm. They're very, very nice, really. We don't complain about it, but it depends about the base. Sometimes, really, they go too fast. You know, when they go 24, you know, that's as in minor quarter, it depends where the jockey he needs to keep his horses, his mm. horse in the race. But so far, I mean, the horse is doing good. As thank God, all the turf and dirt in Dubai, Maidan, it is look good, and we're looking for a good night.
And just talking about some of the horses that we're going back to Europe, Winter Lightning, we don't see her in the UAE Derby. You're going to look at Royal Ascot for her?
Yeah, we'll give her a break. I mean, the filly, I mean, she ran last year in October. And we'll give her one race, and she came here to run well and to win nice races here, even the Guineas. But the filly, she's a little bit weak. I mean, she's more like, I mean, the end of the season for the European season. Then we start for her, we'll give her a break now, we'll start with her for Royal Ascot. Then we go from there. But the filly, she could be like at the end of the season and even more for next year when she becomes 4 years old.
How are you feeling about the 2-year-olds this year? I know you'll have been keeping a close eye on them. Do you think you might have some nice ones in there?
I hope. You know, the horses that came this year, thank God, at least they're sound. You know, I mean, to compare to last year when the horses that came, like 50 horses as unsound, injured, backward. But this year, you know, they're looking good. You know, and I'm so excited for 2018 season, and we're looking to find some stars there.
And when you look back over what 22 Dubai World Cups, Dubai has changed, everything has changed. You've stayed the same, haven't you? It's been an amazing few years.
Well, this is like this game is like what you know is a very tough game, and always you're looking for the best result. As Sheikh Mohammed, he's lead. He's the leader for this team, and he supports us with good horses. You know, sometimes we have some stars, and sometimes you know we have a quiet season. But as what you see, as racing, always up and down, but always we are solid and we try the best.